Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss the next topic of history lesson 1. The topic are, the first one is hunger, hardship and popular revolt. And then we will discuss 1848, the revolution of liberals. First of all, we are going to discuss hunger, hardship and popular revolts. The period 1830 was the period of economic crisis all over the Europe. Actually, due to unemployment, large number of people from rural area migrated to town and cities in search of employment. And in this way, cities became crowded, slums became crowded. Due to increase in population of town and cities, there was also increased demand of food, but there was shortage of food. This shortage of food resulted price rise. Apart from this, the small manufacturer, producers, especially in textile field, due to mechanized product, due to industrialization in England, machine made cloths flooded the market and it created competition for a small manufacturer who used to manufacture cloths in their houses or in countryside. Due to this, there were disorder in the society. People started demanding employment. They rose against price rise, and in this way there was totally atmosphere of disorder. Such situation had been also found in France in 1848. Due to shortage of food, due to price rise, due to unemployment, people of France in Paris came out in large number from their houses, and such crowd just started demanding all those things, means employment. They rose their voice against price rise. The government tried to control the crowd, but it was impossible. At that time, Louis Philippe was the ruler of France. Finally, he was forced to flee away from Paris. At that time, again the National Assembly was set up. All the men had been granted right to vote. This National Assembly also set up National Workshop to provide employment to the people. Whatever the happening that had happened in 1848. The root cause of this happening happened in 1845. Actually, there was a place in Paris, Silesia. In Silesia, large number of weavers worked for contractors. The contractors supplied them raw materials and the weavers prepared goods, means cloth, for them and getting wages. In 1845, weavers demanded increasement of their wages, but contractors did not pay any attention towards the demand of weavers. On the other hand, they reduced their wages. So weavers got angered, and on June 2, in 1848, large number of weavers came out from their houses and reached to contractor mansion, where they started demanding increasement of their wages. But they had been badly treated, they had been threatened. Due to this, the weavers attacked contractor mansion. One of the group just plundered the supplies or the goods that had been stored in the houses of contractors, and the other broke down window pane, furniture, etc. In this way, they forced contractors to flee away from there, and the contractors, along with their families, just flee away and took shelter in neighboring villages. But after 24 hours, the contractors returned in security of forces. At that time, weavers reached there, and there was occurrence of fight. In that fight, 11 weavers had been killed. So in this way, we find the root cause of the happening of 1848. The 11 weavers that had been shot dead, you may say the root cause of happening of 1848. That's all in the first topic. Now we will discuss about the next topic, 1848, the revolution of liberals. In 1848, in many parts of Europe, along with the revolts of peasants, workers, unemployed, parallel to this, there was revolution of educated middle class, means revolution of liberals, revolution of educated men and women. and the liberals demanded unification of nation, information of nation, combining all the region of same languages speaking people. They also demanded a constitution to form parliamentary government, freedom of speech, freedom of press. So in this way, in most part of Europe, you may say in German region, Poland, Austro-Hungary Empire, the same demand was carried on and on by educated middle class. In German region, there was great demand. In German region, there were so many political clubs and they used to elect their representatives. In 1848, all the political clubs came together. These all political organizations came together and decided to vote for all German parliament. On 18th May 1848, 831 elected representatives, just like festive procession. That means you may say that whatever the procession that is taken out during the festival, in the same way the procession had been taken out by the 831 elected representatives. They gathered in St. Paul Church and they declared this assembly as all German parliament, or this church, St. Paul Church, was situated in Frankfurt. That's why it is also known as Frankfurt Parliament. After assembling in the St. Paul Church of Frankfurt, they decided to draft or make constitution to limit the power of king. They prepared a constitution and decided to hand over this constitution to the king of Prussia, because king of Prussia was the ruler of German region. They wanted to do so that king must be forced to rule according to the provision of the constitution. But unfortunately, when representatives of Frankfurt Parliament handed over the constitution to the king of Prussia, means when they asked the ruler of Prussia to rule over German region according to provision of the constitution, he rejected this proposal and joined hand with the ruler of neighboring region, who were against the happening or the development which were taking place. So, since ruler of Persia refused to rule according to the constitution, that's why liberal class people got chance to rule over German region. But unfortunately, they were unable to get full support of the people. People were also against monarchy rule, but most of the people were also against the rule of the liberal class people, educated people. Because the workers who had supported liberals to get power, their demand had not been fulfilled. And due to this, there were always disturbances created by workers and the rulers. Ultimately, the troops had to give up and the rule of educated middle class was over. Anyhow, now you should understand, whatever the happening that happened in German region, in the political organization, whatever the activities that had been carried on by political clubs or organization, women also participated in the same way like men, but they had been denied the equal political rights, equal to men. You should remind that when Frankfurt Parliament had been organized in St. Paul Church, at that time, women were not allowed to sit together with the member of Frankfurt Parliament. And they had been allowed to sit in the audience hall. In this way, they had been not given equal political right to men. And due to this reason, they had to struggle for long to get equal political right to men. But you should know also, after the end of revolution of liberal class people, in most part of the Europe, again there were re-establishment of conservative rule during 1848. But these conservative rulers were not so autocratic. They made so many reforms, they took steps to modernize, because they came to understand that to prevent the activities of liberal class people, there was need of reformation. So they took many steps. Feudal system had been abolished. Feud and serfs were also freed. currency had been issued, banking system, legal system had been started by the conservative ruler. In this way, we have discussed this topic also, and we have finished the two topics. Next day, we will start the next topic. Thank you.